Bueno, siempre toca a las mujeres de ser más cortas, pero bueno. Gracias por invitarnos y además de presentarles el caso de BWin. ¿Qué tiene que ver BWin con lujo? Bueno, como lo ha dicho la arquitecta Teresa, el lujo está en reinventar. Y nosotros nos hemos tomado el lujo de reinventar una industria que no estaba bien visto socialmente. Pero como hemos escuchado ayer, los españoles tienen que aprender un poco más el inglés y por eso voy a hacer esta presentación en inglés. The title is How Do You Become a Digital Brand? You Must Exist Offline. And the case story is BWin. BWin, which most of you know mainly because you've seen it on the shirt of Real Madrid. But we are much more. I have to push now two buttons. Okay. Who is BWin? We are a publicly listed company that offers very high value gaming entertainment on a very multinational level. We are the largest and most innovative player in our niche, and we have an incredible transaction platform that securely performs over 150 payment methods to have millions of people playing concurrent on our system. We are a blue chip product, and we are a global mover and player. But looking into the audience, I'm sure that most of you are not online gamers, and therefore I would kindly request you to take you to a short tour of our real gaming platform. But every story has a beginning, and so do we. Started in the year 99 by two young Austrian entrepreneurs in a kind of a garage kind of company, they had one clear vision. They wanted to make money in the internet. And so they did. They raised 50 million at an IPO in the year 2000. And from there on, with a couple of very enthusiastic young talents, they were able to establish sports betting in the internet for the first time. But since that year, 2000, we have always been innovative in our market. We have redefined ourselves and constantly have been trying to renew the perception and also the products and the services that we deliver. We were the first ones that established sports betting, as I said, in the internet. We were the first one that integrated fully web-supported betting services. And in the year 2000, we did something that was very crucial for the web community. We made betting a much more entertainment proposition by establishing and introducing live betting. Live betting is an instant gratification and enhances the entertainment values while you are watching a football game, for instance. You have an immediate enhancement of the entertainment value of only watching TV, which, as we know, most of the young kids don't do anyhow. They have the multitasking of having various displays to enhance their experience. So from the first day on, we have kept on redefining ourselves. But in the year 2005, we were already the most successful and the biggest European sports bettor. But we knew that in this highly competitive market, it is very difficult to sustain, especially as all the products that we were offering are commodities. I mean, let's face it, sports betting, poker can be copied, and that's what we've been doing all the time. So to develop a sustainable differentiation, to keep ahead of our competitors, we knew that we had to reposition ourselves to not be only a product, but to become a brand. So the next exciting chapter of our brand was to find out what are the real motives behind the game. So we conducted the most extensive consumer research ever done in our industry to find out that users wanted to have a kick by being right or being wrong. This insight has enabled us to dwell on it and to make out of it a gaming proposition. So we shifted from a product to become a brand that kept on leading the category and to transform also our product offering by not just offering one product, but many of them, to become a house of game, a house of entertainment where users come in and can decide upon themselves what game they're going to play today. But having said so, we wanted not to stay in that category that we were defining. We wanted to become gambling. We wanted to get out of gambling and become much more gaming. Because the redefinition of the category was key for our success, because most people felt that gambling is something that has to do with people that have no job and or it's in the environment of prostitutes. So we took it out of there and we made it an entertainment proposition. Entertainment proposition meaning that it's about playing. It is not the reward. Gambling is defined by making money and winning a lot of money. We have never communicated money. We have always communicated that what we are giving is an entertainment proposition. So to find a position in day-to-day environment of consumers, which is the only way to become really relevant as a brand, was to give them the feeling that this is a play for real proposition in which you can sense yourself and outplay every day. But by doing so, going from gambling to gaming, we also took a very big financial risk, because we went from a market niche where very few made, we made a lot of money on them, to go to a mass market. By not focusing anymore on the stakes, which is most of the industry is doing, they're persuading people to play by bonuses, we were focusing on the game proposition. From few customers to many, and from a high margin to a lower margin, which can only business-wise be survived if we really attract a new potential. And the new potential for us was a new target audience, which is from gamblers to gamers. Gamers are people that are looking for entertainment propositions in the internet. Today in Europe, we have 60 million constantly growing, 45% already women, and are all these young kids that grew up on PlayStations and now really are looking for more challenges once they become adults. They are also four times larger than just the bettors. We know that bettors are more or less like 3% of the male population above 18. And gamers are very, very reputation and ambassador savvy, which is what you need to sustain nowadays, because who is talking about you? Your reputation has to be made in social media. So having said so, we went from repositioning ourselves to a more popular proposition, attracting a new audience with one single objective. We wanted to become a brand, and a brand has to fulfill or has to solve a problem that the user has in his day-to-day life. Just as Google did, I mean, they are a search engine. Their category didn't exist before, but they established a category and they owned it. The same was done with Wikipedia and with eBay. eBay is a marketplace which mainly a gaming proposition to take something away from somebody else. So our clear target is to take a proposition which is feel the thrill and adrenaline of playing for real by becoming the ultimate thrill station. And like everything we did, it was a big objective and we did everything to fulfill it. But we had one big obstacle. BWin was called Bet and Win. And that was a brand name that is not able to carry emotion, and it was much too specific for the first product we were offering, which was sport betting. So we did something that most other people would not have dared to do. We changed our name, Bet and Win, and at that time already highly invested in marketing, to BWin, which was just a shortcut to new playing grounds.
Be part of it. BWin.
Doing this was a step to not only an operational nightmare. We changed on the 1st of August in the year 2008. We changed 8,000 applications, our complete online communication. You could not find the old logo anymore within 24 hours. It was an operational masterpiece. And it was also something that implemented our total management system, because we implemented customer experience in all our do's and routes. This is easily said than done, because especially if you are such a complex product as we are, you have to put the emotion and the experience of the customer beyond the product advice. Having done so, in the year 2006, after the World Championship, we had a very big success, because at that same time we had political problems and very high PR coverage, and in all that PR coverage, they always transferred the name change. It was also BWin, former Bet and Win, or Bet and Win, now BWin. So that helped us a lot, but it was not done by communication, it was done by PR. But we are not talking about products. As I said before, all the products that we are delivering are commodities. It is the customer experience. It's the customer who desires if you are good enough, if you're going to survive, and if he is satisfied with what you're offering, he's going to talk about it. So especially for a digital brand, you really depend on the transformation and the ambassador qualities of your users. But having rebranded was also key because we needed to be existent offline. If you are a digital service, you have to be relevant, visible, and have a public awareness outside of your of the web. To do that, we wanted to have top clubs like Real Madrid and AC Milan that would have never carried Bet and Win on their breast, but they did BWin. And with BWin and the board, we have been able to have a very high visibility in day-to-day television and to get public awareness, which helped us to make our brand part of day-to-day life. But we did not only rebrand the outside, we had to build in the complexity of our system, the customer experience, because we know a user is depending on the convenience, on the emotion, on his ubiquity, but also he wants to feel that this is all custom made for him. And that was the most difficult part. It took us, after the rebranding, more than a year to implement customer experience into our complex product. But especially as a digital brand, you don't exist only in advertising. You have a behavior that determines you, because once the person comes into your site, it's the way it's being talked to. It's the way how customer support helps you. It's the way how your payment methods work. It's the way how the mailings work, and especially how you are being attracted to come to the site. And we were able to have most of our traffic directed mainly only by people who were unreferred. They were typing in BWin because they would become obvious of the brand outside of the web to go and visit it themselves and to make their own opinion. But last but not least, it's not what we think we are, it's what they think we are. And the user centricity is key to build up emotional relationship. And to have become a brand was not only important to get a social acceptance, it was also to develop that everything we were doing in and out the web has the same tonality and the same matter. So therefore, we developed a creative strategy that was for everybody a guidance that the repositioning can be followed up by saying, BWin is the ultimate thrill station for modern gladiators. Let's face it, the web is a reproduction of your ego. You can have a reputation in the web much quicker than you can in the offline world. So a modern gladiator is a metaphor of people that want to show off their skills and want to be better than others. They want to have that social competition and they want to be seen while they do so. Offering them the possibility to outplay every day, something we don't get enough. Most of our life is being determined by the stress, by the work, by the wife, by the traffic. When do you have the moment of really deciding something upon your gut feeling? We offer this. So we call this outplaying every day, which is a relevant benefit for more than just one, to get the main thing that we all need. It's an ego kick. Even if I'm right or if I'm wrong, I get the ego kick that I was trusting my own gut and my own instincts by playing for real. We took play for real, which is inherent in our industry, to our claim. It's a little bit the same like other category definers. It's if you have a determinator of what you're offering and you own it as a leader, then you can become the leader of the market. So having said so, we introduced
enough
it with this campaign.
Is enough. Enough with the manicures, the pedicures, and the smelling like sweet, sweet flowers. We refuse to believe that men like to make themselves ridiculous. Real men are loud.
They shout, they yell.
They build things and break things.
We want our men back!
Men need challenges.
Men need victory!
Thank you. But this was mainly done also for the German market, because there they wanted to close us again. And it is exactly what I tried to explain before. You make a promise much more popular and relevant to everybody that if you want to play for real, it's fine. It's your personal decision. And a real man has to make decisions. And as we have used it in a lot of our wordings, a bet or an opinion, that's all what you have to make a determination of yourself, driven by the inner you. So with the launch of BWin, we established a brand-focused company model. In all our management decisions, the brand was always the key driver, because that was a sustainable differentiation that we had in such a competitive environment in which we are living today. So we also had to change our vision on marketing. We went from a product-centric approach, which is sports betting in the internet, to brand-centric, but then knowing that the only survivable item we have is the user acceptance. So the user has to be in the middle of everything we do. But having said all of this, we also knew that marketing-wise, we could not keep up spending that kind of money to sustain in offline communication, because 95% of our communication is online. And if you are advertising in this way, you have to have the money to say, because you could be confused with an offline brand. So we needed to be in our 360-degree communication much more precise, and we had to give our whole look a digital touch. So what we did is we took our in-house developed technology, which we called Shiva, which is a widget layer technology, to bring that into communication channels to give the web experience be also seen offline. So I show you one of our last commercials.
BWin.
So what you have seen here, it's unmistakably a digital service. It is the interactivity that you are in the middle of the game, you are the one that makes the choices, and you are the one that is enhancing his experience while he's watching a game, because he's betting on it at the same time live. Last but not least, BWin is digital, and as a web brand, you can't feel it, you can't touch it, you can't smell it, you can't go to an outlet like most of our competitors do, and they have the attributes and the history of being offline brands, and they take it only to the online environment. User centricity and offline relevance is key to success, and brand awareness. I mean, brand awareness is number one as a business driver. If you're not being remembered, nobody's going to type in that name when he's at home in his computer. So we have conducted extensive studies all around the globe to watch if all the repositioning and all the strategic work we have done out of our gut feeling is really...